Hello, everyone. The third eye is taking you to see the world. Today, I will bring you a topic of mysterious Untersberg Mountain. About this mountain, there are too many mysterious legends and peculiar events, which are enough to write a series of novels. The locals even think this is a holy mountain that protects them, because they believe the mountain has great energy and predictive ability. To say that the Untersberg is located in Salzburg, Austria, actually it is not accurate. Because two-thirds of this mountain range is in Germany, but the Salzburgians still stubbornly call this mountain Hausberg, which means this is a local mountain. Well, to consider the feelings of Salzburgians, let's say this. From a geographical point of view, this mountain is straddling the border between Berchtesgaden, Germany, and Salzburg, Austria. The highest two peaks of the mountain are the highest peak Berchtesgaden Hochthurn at 1,973 meters, and the second peak Salzburger Hochthurn at 1,853 meters. Interestingly, there are many caves in the 70 square kilometers of mountains, including the famous sightseeing ice cave Schellenberger Eichel, Germany's pit cave Riesendingschachtel, which is the deepest and longest in Germany, and it is the longest 19.5 kilometers and 1,148 meters, the deepest. There are endless magical stories about these caves, so the mountain was given many aliases by the locals, such as Zauberberg, Wunderberg, Berg de Lix, which means Magic Mountain, Wonder Mountain, Light Mountain. These names are well deserved. Many cases and research results can demonstrate the peculiarities of this mountain range. For example, the priest Joseph Schmatzberger, who lives in the small town of Grossgmai at the foot of the Untersberg Mountain. He has detected that the energy flow in the town is particularly strong. He built a Marian column in the church garden, behind which is the Untersberg Mountain range clearly visible. Schmatzberger said that if people pray facing the column, either stand or kneel, sometimes the powerful energy from the Untersberg Mountains is strong enough to knock people down. Rainer Limpach, 53, lives in the small town of Einring, which is close to the Untersberg Mountain range. He said with certainty that the mountains resonate, and this mountain is the prophet of all events in the world. 3 years ago, before the strong earthquake in the Himalayas, there was a landslide in the Untersberg Mountain range. The debris stained the water of the Weissbach stream red. He took photos at the time. He thought it was an early warning, but at the time people didn't know what was going to happen. Some people said these were coincidences, but Limpach believes that the Earth is an organism, and events to events are closely related. If people can deeply understand these so-called supernatural phenomena, they will avoid a lot of misfortune. Many mountaineering accidents could be avoided. Limpach said that on June 8, 2014, cave researcher Johann Westhauser had an accident while climbing Untersberg. At that time, a world-famous 9-day rescue was launched. In the end, Westhauser survived. Just 1 year later, on June 7, 2015, a rescuer of previous year died in this mountain. "This is fate," Limpach said. "It's known since ancient times that this mountain cannot be climbed during Pentecost, and people should take these things seriously." Various legends cast a magical veil on the Untersberg Mountain. In addition, the modern writer Wolfgang Stadler also had magical experiences there, and wrote these experiences into a series of novels, Power of Stones. His pen name is Stanwolf. Stanwolf said in an interview that several time holes are hidden in the mountain. There he found a metal door through which he could enter the depths of the mountain. People from another era live there. The time inside is 300 times slower than outside. To stay inside for a day, 1 year outside has passed. It seemed incredible and caused many people's doubts. The author then clarifies that he did not mention many of the experiences that he encountered. As per him, the human mind accepts only what can be seen clearly. He had purposely tagged his work as that of fiction. According to his website, the background of his novel comes from a disappearance case. On August 15, 1987, three Germans disappeared without a trace at Untersberg near Salzburg, who wanted to research the temporal phenomenon occurring there. This triggered the largest search operation that ever took place on the Untersberg. 152 men and three helicopters were on the search for over a week without discovering anything of the three. After more than 2 months, these people reported from a cargo ship in the Red Sea. The author met these Germans a few years before they disappeared in a refuge on the mountain and then began to research meticulously for 15 years to find out what he was discovered and found out. Then he could only publish as a novel. So far, no one is able to explain exactly these magical things. An even strange account is said to have taken place in 1858, when an entire wedding procession claimed that as they walked a mountain path on their way to the wedding reception, a rock wall opened up from which emerged an elderly, gray-haired man who invited them to follow him. When the group went through the mysterious passage, they found themselves in a vast city under the mountain with a plenitude of gold, jewels, and luxurious surroundings. The party was treated to an opulent buffet of food and drink, and then supposedly fell asleep. When they woke, they found themselves in different surroundings amongst people who spoke strangely and wore odd clothing. They made it back to the church where the wedding had taken place, but even this place seemed different, and the priest was also a different person. When they told the priest what had happened and asked where the rest of the wedding was, but he had no idea of what they were talking about. The priest decided to look into it and found that a wedding procession had vanished in the area, but the most bizarre detail of all was that they had disappeared over 100 years before. The best well-known legend of Untersberg Mountain is about that there are king and emperor living in the mountain. A king named Charlemagne or Charles the Great has been called the father of Europe. King of Heart in the French version of playing cards is Karl the Great. It's said he is sleeping for centuries somewhere in a cave of empty Untersberg. The dwarfs are taking care of him until he wakes up after a century. When he wakes up and sees the ravens still flying around the mountain, he falls into a deep sleep for another century. If doesn't see the ravens when he wakes up, the last day will come, or the world will transform to new status. The king in another version of the legend is the Emperor Frederick Barbarossa, nicknamed Redbeard. It's said he is asleep in the mountain until his beard grows long enough to complete the third circle around a table. Once it does, the emperor will resurrect and leave MT Untersberg. This will herald a terrific war of humankind near Salzburg, and eventually, the world will come to an end. Legend of Redbeard King is similar to a miracle story that has been circulating in Christianity for nearly 2,000 years. This miracle talks about seven young Christians. They hid inside a cave of Mount Pion near the city of Ephesus, just have a sleep. Then 200 years passed when they woke up. The Grotto of the Seven Sleepers with ruins of the religious site built over it was excavated in 1926 to 1928. According to the Golden Legend and Roman Martyrology, the story says that during the persecutions by the Roman Emperor Decius, around 250 AD, seven young men were accused of following Christianity. They were given some time to renounce their faith, but they refused to bow to Roman idols. Instead, they chose to give their wealth to the poor and go to a mountain cave to pray. The emperor, seeing that their attitude had not improved, ordered to seal the mouth of cave. 200 years passed, during which Christianity went from being persecuted to being the state religion of the Roman Empire. At 450 AD, during the reign of Theodosius II, the persecution to Christianity has ended. A landowner decided to open up the sealed mouth of the cave for some reason, and found the sleepers inside. They awoke, imagining that they had slept but one day. Upon arriving at Ephesus City, they astounded to find buildings with crosses attached, churches have been in the city, Christianity has been the state religion of the Roman Empire. The Bishop of Ephesus was summoned to interview the sleepers. The Emperor Theodosius II, hearing what had happened, hastened to the spot in time to hear from their lips that God had wrought this wonder to confirm his faith in the resurrection of the dead. This message was delivered, they again fell asleep. The emperor began preparing elaborate reliquaries for their bodies, but they appeared to him in a dream and asked to be put back into the earth to await the final resurrection. People didn't want to disturb the seven sleepers who were sleeping in the cave again. Instead, they again sealed the mouth of the cave and built a church to worship the sleepers. After several wars, the ancient city of Ephesus and the cave of the seven saints were all turned into ruins. It was discovered by the German archaeological expedition in the 1930s. The place known as the Grotto of the Seven Sleepers is now a ruined church carved into the rock. In the side walls of the church, there are niches with arched vaults. The inscriptions dedicated to the seven sleepers were found on the walls. The Ephesus people believe the seven saints will awaken on the day of judgment, once again walk out of the cave to meet the King of Kings with the believers. There are many miraculous wonders in religion, which are enlightening the conscience and kindness of the world. It is God's grace and revelation to man. When the morals of humans have been corrupted to the point of hopelessness, mankind faces a moment of destruction. In both Eastern and Western cultures mentioned the Savior, who will come to save the world. Who is the Savior? For thousands of years, mankind has been waiting for his arrival. Due to cultural differences, in the Hebrew civilization, the Messiah recorded in the Old Testament is the future God who will save the Jews in the future. Therefore, the name of the Savior in West is Messiah. According many prophecies, Messiah is named as Savior, Creator, Eastern Saint or King of Kings as well. And we believe that the blessed person who can pass to the new era of the future will be same as the seven saints sleepers to welcome the arrival of the King of Kings. Please have a good preparation for this great moment. The third eye is taking you to see the world. That's all for today. Thanks for your attention. We will bring you more interesting topics next time. Thanks for your likes, subscribe and share. If have any comment, please leave your message below. Thank you, bye-bye.
感谢大家嘅观看，下期节目我哋将同大家带嚟新嘅话题。感谢你嘅点赞、订阅同分享。如果你有啲咩感想，请俾我哋点评留言啦。